first page in, the yin yang symbol, that really shows Meridian Yoga kind of in a nutshell. There's more than these poses for each meridian. Here we have a chart of Meridian Yoga, and if you look at it, it's numbered. I started with gallbladder, upper right-hand corner. That's not necessarily because meridian flow begins in gallbladder, it just was convenient in a way. Gallbladder goes to liver, liver goes to lungs, lungs go to large intestine to stomach, and if you notice, under each, in the bold, it says the name of the meridian, which almost always is connected to an organ in the body. And then underneath it in the italics are some of the elements that are connected with that meridian. In other words, gallbladder rules all the ligaments of the body. It's in charge of decision making. Liver rules all the tendons of the body and is the official in charge of the flow of prana, the energy in your body. So if it's smooth flow or it's erratic flow. Lungs, intake of prana. That's pretty obvious. Large intestine elimination, apana. In yoga, it would be called apana. Stomach, muscles, logical thinking, and so on and so forth. And I've conveniently divided up with, these are two of friends of mine, two yoga teachers, Aaron Kanner and Carrie Tyler. Carrie's modeling all the yin meridians. Aaron is modeling all the yang meridians. In the middle, we have conception vessel, governing vessel, because these stand apart. They're the ones that rule, the conception vessel rules all the yin meridians. It's a reservoir for yin in the body. The governing vessel rules all the yang meridians. It's the reservoir for yang energy in the body.